Welcome to the Plan B channel, where we provide information about HIV treatment that is accurate, up-to-date, and unbiased. My name is Ben Plumley. I'm a global AIDS activist and strategist committed to helping people with HIV find information about treatment, make treatment decisions that enable them to live long and healthy lives. In this episode, we are going to talk about HIV and hepatitis B co-infection. And I'm delighted that we're joined by Dr. Royce Lynn, an HIV specialist from the United States of America and associate clinical professor at the University of California in San Francisco. Dr. Lynn, welcome back to Plan B Channel.
Thank you, Ben, and thank you, everybody.
So a question that has come in from a number of patients is about HIV and hepatitis B co-infection. Do you see this in your patient groups in the United States? And what is the treatment strategy that you adopt for patients who are co-infected?
Yes. So hepatitis B is definitely an infection that we see throughout the world. Certain parts of the globe, particularly Asia, for example, there's a higher prevalence of hepatitis B. So it's very important for us to talk about the intersection between HIV and hepatitis B. And the reason why that's important is that, as it turns out, there are some medications that are active against both hepatitis B and HIV at the same time. For somebody who has has hepatitis B only, sometimes they can be treated with just one medication. But in people who have hepatitis B and HIV, you can't just pay attention to the hepatitis B, you have to pay attention to HIV as well. So in general, we want to start people on HIV and hepatitis B treatment at the same time, and with medications that are active against both viruses. What are those medications? So there are four, and they're all medications that are very, very commonly used in HIV treatment. So two out of those are 3TC or FTC. They're very similar medications. And they can be used for the most part interchangeably. So that's one pair. Another medication that is active against both HIV and hepatitis B is tenofovir. And that includes tenofovir disoproxilfumarate, or TDF, and the newer version called TAF, or tenofovir alafelamide. So in general, when I am working with somebody who has both HIV and hepatitis B, I will include 3TC or FTC plus one of the two formulations of tenofovir as the backbone of the treatment for my patient. And those two medications will work together to treat not just HIV, but hepatitis B as well. Couple of considerations though. So one is that if somebody is stopping treatment for HIV, that means that they're actually stopping treatment for hepatitis B as well. So if somebody is on a treatment regimen, but they decide to stop for whatever reason, one thing that as a physician I am mindful of is that my patient may develop a flare of hepatitis B, because when you stop the HIV treatment, you're also stopping the hepatitis B treatment. When we start HIV treatment, we also are starting hepatitis B treatment. And what we want to see is for both the HIV viral load and the hepatitis B viral load to get to undetectable on your treatment regimen.
Well, that's very helpful news, Dr. Lynn. Thank you very much indeed. And thank you very much for watching. In a moment, a screen will come up with links that will connect you with information about hepatitis B and HIV treatment in your country. And there will also be links connecting you with us here at Plan B. We'd love to hear from you with your questions and your concerns. Thanks for watching.